สวัสดีครับสวัสดีครับ
สวัสดีค่ะ so they really want to you know take care of these because they're so special they first recorded male and female twins in Thailand and then shortly up like in the world but then in Myanmar they had some like male and female twins did you see that
I did not know
okay I'm so somebody wrote on my wall from there and said and posted the camp so I know which camp it is now but because it's Burma nobody really pays attention and that's a problem because there's another thing like oh it's happening in some country that doesn't count or so, I don't know like it's really weird anyway
I will in a minute yeah just watching and listening right now
yeah so it's really important that people kind of you know like I'm trying to sort of make people aware that you know these are the countries that have the experience I would have imagined you've read Elephant Bill Have you read Elephant Bill?
No, I haven't. I've heard of it, yeah, but I haven't.
I would definitely recommend it because it really is about this whole thing of the... It's in English, you know, of a British experience of, you know, using the elephants during war. And also, like, looking after the camps, but just telling it how it is without an agenda.
Yeah.
Very interesting because you're not, no one's trying, you know, he's got recording and it's a fascinating thing. Like you are, you're fascinating. So they were born June 7th. At, like at night. And so the mother tried to kill her. When she came out 18 minutes after, but fortunately, the Mohuts, you know, they just don't care. They just got in there. Like everyone was screaming. We were all there. There were so many of us there because we did not expect them to. We didn't know she was having twins. No one knows when they're having twins. No, she's had a few babies, but she was like, what the hell's that? You know, like, because no one's had twins here before. And so, yeah, the Mohuts just ran in and they, like, saved her. And then after everything calmed down, then
they
reintroduced and she's absolutely fine. And that's what, you know, we always manage to do. You're always, I don't know what you're doing with your mouth all the time. You're just up in there.
I know, especially first-time mothers or birds that they haven't seen a birth. They'll get in there prepared to pull, the first thing they'll do is pull the baby just because they don't want to take that chance.
Yeah, you know? And how are they going to do that if it's all free contact?
Well, and so what they're, so programs that have experienced contact, like Houston Zoo, have free contact previously before the ADA mandated that. They were still allowed to go in and if the elephant was tethered, they could go in with them. So they put front and backs on them. On the female when she was getting ready to give birth and they would all be around her and then as soon as they hit the ground they'd take the push broom and push the baby to the other side and there'd be somebody to grab the baby and pull it.
Hear the voice she makes?
Yeah.
Like a frog? You're a weirdo. She doesn't do it.
She does.
Is that what
she did
too?
Like she did this clicking thing. She would click, you know. She would also, you know, in Africans they'll purr kind of thing too. But she also did click and things with her tongue.
So these are like the miracle and
I'm gonna go home and dad now. I've brought out the forms for Linda and Janet and the pens. But I've told Lexi you're on this.
Oh, okay. He seems to like choking on stuff. Like, I think he's like a stupid.
เอาเห็นขนมปังไม่ได้
ไ
ม่จ้างเห็นขนมปังแล้วความมับความมับแล้วใช่โอ้ยสวยเลือกได้สวยเลือกได้ตอนนี้โอ้สาธุ